All right, there, YouTubers. Oh, these smell lush. Oh, chocolate cupcakes. Oh, look at that. Fucking lovely. Let's put that on so you can see. Referendum coming back with a deal with the Labour Party. That's much more. How you can get out of this hole. These, at least I'm not starting in my beard. Oh, these chocolate cupcakes. Oh, smell lovely, YouTube.
Pressure to do this, so wise move. Well, I'm joined by the Skeptic and Michael.
Oh, yeah.
I think, do you applaud Mr. Cameron's decision?
I do applaud it. Former government whip, I think, is a particularly wise move of him to do it. But as you quite rightly say, there was a precedent with Wilson doing it as well.
They are lovely.
And he's done it all right. What do you say to the likes of Ken Clark, who say if you allow ministers to argue against each other on such an important issue, it would be really impossible to bring them together again, which will inevitably be bitter?
Oh, yeah.
Well, I love Ken Clark. But
that deserves a bit of cream on them, my lad.
From the Masters, so we don't want to go back to that again.
Bit of cream.
Harold Wilson did that as well. And I think it would be far more bloody and far more damaging had he not allowed it.
I'll put a long time down, never mind.
I used to be a government whip, and lots of things we do is really do things by persuasion.
Oh, chocolate cupcake, man, lovely.
It wasn't like half the power, if you remember, the government chief whip threw somebody over about anything.
Looking lovely, you too.
It's far more popular. I'm sure that the government chief whip
That's what life's about, mate.
This is the right thing to do. And David Cameron is right to have taken that advice and to ignore the advice of the likes of Sir John Major, Michael Heseltine, senior figures who've been around this course already, who have already said, do not allow your party to vote this and just fuel the divisions. But senior figures who are your own party, and senior figures who are not now wearing the mantle of high office being Prime Minister, albeit that they did hold. So, David Cameron is a pragmatist, likes getting things done, and he wants to do it in a way that will be as net damaging as possible. And this is the way to do it. But doesn't it also say that the deal he brings back from Brussels undermines that very deal? Because it's saying, oh, well, I know it's not that great a deal. You can campaign against it if you want.
Fucking lovely, YouTube. Fucking taste lovely.
And being, you know, you're a skeptic like me, will take even if we got many of the things that David Cameron.
That's what life's about.
You know, I just believe that countries like Australia, New Zealand, Canada, other independent countries with far smaller populations in the world than us would make it extraordinary if other countries had the power over us that the European Union does. And quite frankly,
they were over there.
Only cabinet to expect to campaign against Britain's membership of the EU. Norman Georgia probably better than mine. And I'm certainly not going to speak to that. So do you think it increases the chance?
Bon appetit. They were fucking lovely, YouTubes. They were lovely. Yeah.